private Varsity in honor of Technical Sergeant First Class Kenneth A. Schaeffer. Kenneth Schaeffer graduated from Reading High School, where he was captain of the Varsity Football team. He enlisted in the U.S. Army in September 1942. He was awarded the Good Conduct Medal, Victory Medal, Bronze Star Medal, POW Medal, and the Combat Infantry Badge. Kenneth landed in Normandy in June 1944 with the 4th Armored Division. Staff Sergeant Schaeffer was a squad leader in A Company, 10th Mechanized Infantry Regiment. He fought behind German lines through France to within 50 miles of the German border. During the Arracourt campaign, Staff Sergeant Schaeffer's forward outpost was overrun by a German Panzer Division, and he was taken prisoner. He was interrogated and shipped to Stalag 3C. He was imprisoned for 3 months until Russian troops advanced on the camp. The Germans ordered the prisoners to march from the camp in the ensuing confusion under attack from the Russians. Staff Sergeant Schaeffer escaped. He joined up with 2 fellow POWs, and they trekked through the snow for an undetermined number of days and eventually found themselves at the Red Cross station in Lotiz, Poland. From Poland, Staff Sergeant Schaeffer traveled to Odessa, Russia, and ordered a ship back to the United States. He was promoted to Technical Sergeant First Class, completed military service at Camp Crawl, South Carolina. He is still alive and doing well today at 97 years old. He lives here locally. Unfortunately, he was not able to join us here at the ballpark tonight. But here as a guest of 761, please welcome representing the friends and family of Technical Sergeant First Class Kenneth A. Schaeffer, close friend, Mr. Robert Libutti. Please fall down, how about a round of applause for the friends and family of today's 761 ceremony flag honoree, Kenneth A. Schaeffer. The family will present him with a team autograph baseball and the ceremonial flag that currently flies in front of the stadium. As you exit, we ask that you please pause to view the ceremonial flag in front of the stadium. And remember, Kenneth A. Schaeffer, an American hero. We thank 761 for sponsoring this tribute to our military heroes. Ladies and gentlemen, as we continue down here past the 761 dugout, in keeping with our military appreciation theme, and thanks to our friends from 761, as part of the POW-MIA National Chair of Honor program, it is now time to dedicate one empty seat here at First Energy Stadium. Joining us here tonight, once again, is Mr. Robert Libutti, close friend of our ceremonial flag honoree, Kenneth A. Schaeffer, who was a prisoner of war. Tonight and every night, remember those who became prisoners of war or missing in action. And once again, as I direct your attention to the right field grandstand, just beyond the dugouts here, beginning with tonight's game and for every game here forward, America's Classic Ballpark will feature as POW-MIA National Chair of Honor. One empty seat in every game, honoring all prisoners of war and missing in action. At this time, we are ready to unveil the Chair of Honor. Mr. Robert Libutti, on behalf of your good friend Kenneth A. Schaeffer, and on behalf of all prisoners of war and all missing in action, we please now unveil this meaningful memorial, the POW-MIA National Chair of Honor.
Bob.
With the chair stands the flag that reads, "You are not forgotten." World War I, more than 92,000 American soldiers are unaccounted for. This heavy chair will serve as an instant reminder of all the sacrifices made for our country by these still missing in action servicemen who have for too long been forgotten by all of their immediate families and close friends. We thank Rolling Thunder for their cooperation. Rolling Thunder's major function is to publicize the POW-MIA issue. Rolling Thunder is committed to helping American veterans from all wars. Special thanks again to Mr. Robert Libutti for being here tonight representing his good friend, Kenneth Schaeffer. And we once again thank Savage 61 for sponsoring our military activities. A final round of applause once again in memory of all POW